JRA 501 here. I'm in the Inquisitor. And this is a really, really stupid article, but it was so stupid that I just had to bring it up. Gay men penis size study funded by taxpayer dollars. Regardless of what some economic experts may say, we are not out of the clear when it comes to the Great Recession, and therefore, we shouldn't be spending money on ridiculous studies such as the National Institutes of Health survey, which attempted to tie the size of gay men's penises with their preferences to be on top or bottom. The study, funded in part with taxpayer money, was meant to tie the size of a gay man's penis with their choice of being on the top or the bottom, and was found that men with bigger penises tend to be on top in the relationship, while men with smaller penises often gravitate towards the bottom role in the relationship. Researchers also claim that gay men with smaller penises tend to be more psychologically troubled than men with larger penises. The National Development and Research Institute received money from the NIH to conduct the study, which began in 2006. Money from the program has been provided since 1985 and is often used for behavioral science research on drug abuse, AIDS, and crime, which the group claim their study fit into. Okay, to me, I tried to actually look this up to see how much money was actually spent on this, but I couldn't find the trail. So I've just pretty much come to the conclusion that the only person that really, people that benefited from this survey were the Catholic priests. Okay. That's where our tax dollars are going. Peace out.